Today we're looking at a new junction box from Wago. Okay, I'm sure the boffins over there in Germany, we're going to probably call it Wago throughout the presentation, have come up with a snappy new name for this junction box.
Bit of a challenge there, Gary, because obviously Wagobox is gone. Yes, it was clearly a meeting went on and they came up with a snappy title of 2074301.
Oh, as I like to call it, the 2074301 box from Wago. Okay.
Yeah, so it's a new junction box, clearly aimed at the market for central heating, underfloor heating, things like that. We've previously looked at a previous incarnation of this product, the L32, which, yeah, great idea, but didn't quite hit the mark. Check out that video. But let's have a look at some of the features on this one, Garrett, see what's been improved.
Okay, so first of all, you can see no screws on the front, and we know Wago are renowned for being screwless terminals, so of course the box itself now has no screws on the front, unlike its predecessor. It's a little easier to do it when it's actually physically screwed to the wall, but I'll just show you. Take your screwdriver, just push it in, hear a little click, in again, and then we can just lever that up. So if I just do that with the hand cam, if you want to just take that for me, Gordon,
yep.
So we can have a little look on hand cam. So I've got it in that position, push down, and then hopefully you can just lever the two apart. So there's one that side, and one that side.
I heard that click there, Gary. Clearly you've been rehearsing that.
I've had a few attempts, yes, thank you. So lid out the way, and you can see inside it, what are you noticing straight away, Gordon, that is actually missing?
There's no Wago terminal blocks.
No, it's down to you to install, and it only takes the 221s. The 221s yourself, you have to install those.
Okay. Give you the two-way one as well.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, you go. You've got the set, so you can click them in what positions?
Anywhere you like. So we've got a rail on the top, the sides, and one in the center here that all will accept these connectors into place. Okay, so we can push those into here and then they lock into place. Okay, you can move it along if you've got it in the wrong place as well, and in order to release it, you just press down here with a screwdriver. Okay, and if you've gone across two of them, just press in both sections and you'll be able to lift that back out again, Gordon.
Very nice.
It is.
And what else did you get in the bag?
Yeah, I've got some handy cord grips. In its predecessor, the L32, there wasn't enough positions that you could bring flexes in.
Yes, that was one of the things. We ran out of two things. It was, yeah, entries, cable entry points, and yeah, terminal space as well. So yeah, particularly on the CPC conductors.
Yeah, so we've got six positions here, but that doesn't mean, Gordon, that you can only bring six flexes in, because you can actually piggyback them. So if I insert one of these in like so, just push it into place, you then just simply put the flex in and then you clip that down on top, and it works a bit like a tie wrap. These zip down into position, but what you can do then is put another one on. So in a minute I'll expect a demonstration from you on that. Okay. So we pop those into position. The actual box itself is IP2X and can only withstand an ampere rating of 18 amps. Now,
Okay, we don't want to go into the discussion about aggregate current rating. That's another video. Yeah, so you can't, yeah, 18 amps is the maximum limit for all our circuits flowing through that box.
It is. And people can become confused because the actual connectors themselves, when you look at them, they're rated at 32 amps, depending on where you are, but we're 32 amps here in Europe. And that doesn't mean the box is rated at 32 amps, it's rated at 18. So ideally suited for central heating systems, like the one we've got set up behind us, and maybe lighting circuit connections, yeah. Gordon.
So you wouldn't be using it to extend possibly the conductors coming into a consumer unit to add to move to another location?
Absolutely not. It's not designed to extend cables when you're moving consumer units at all. So with that in mind, okay, we've got the 60 positions now to make our connections, considerably more than we had on the original one. Mm. So it means that we can fully populate it for the central heating system that we're looking at in this video.
Yeah.
It's also rated at 450 volts as well. So
okay, well, let's have a look at that cable clamp, Gary.
Okay, you're going to have a little go at this one.
I'll have a go at that, yeah.
Right, okay. Let's bring this camera in. So we've got the original upstands are in. Okay, I'll pop those in. So you're going to put one of these in.
You're right. That does look like a cable tie.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, and it sounds like one as well.
Push down there.
Wow.
Yeah, so I've pushed that. Again, it's not coming out.
No screws. Lovely.
No, but the good thing is, yeah, you can stack another cable on top. I mean, if I look at the box itself, you can see it's got knockouts to allow a single or a double cable entry as well.
Okay.
So you can double stack them. So
okay, you're going to double stack one for me?
Just bring in another one.
Oh, neatly prepared earlier. So pop that on. Again, love that.
Now, the next thing you think, how do I release those? just on the side there, you'll see there's a tiny little indent there to put a screwdriver in.
Yep.
So you sort of prise it apart, and then that comes out. So a ratchet release mechanism, a bit like you'd have on a cable tie. Not most of them, because they're not reusable. But.
Okay, so we've got two here, two. So that gives us our 12, doesn't it? We can have six, or we can double stack them to make 12 flexible cables coming in.
And you also get this labelling strip that's got cut points on the back.
Okay.
So that slots into the slot here to label up, obviously, the configuration that you've done. So one slight thing I found on this, we use a Brother label printer with a 12 millimeter ribbon.
Okay.
I'd say that's about 11 millimeters. So there's, going to be a...
Yeah.
Yeah, nearly there. One slight thing, I guess, that's a slight downside.
The other thing I found with the L32 is I couldn't fit it on to say if I flushed in a box into the wall. Okay, so we've got a socket box here. Yeah. If I flush that in, the likely is I would like to fit...
well, you would do that, wouldn't you? Because chances are, if you don't fit that, what's the plasterer going to do? Yeah, well, okay, he's going to fill it up anyway. But at least you've got a fighting chance if you've first fixed the back box.
And if we take this one, so again, if you want to take it in and have a look for us, we've got the ability now just to drop it on top of a twin socket box.
There they are. So
one this side. Yeah, clearly see that you can actually fit those on there. And you've got three points there also that you can come in through the back of that box as well.
Yeah, and there's this additional space for the terminals as well.
That's
good.
So I think we can clearly see then that if I cut away to this shot, that actually now the original one that we set up, check out that video, it's a really good one. But now we've changed nothing else, only changed the box, haven't we? We've changed over to this new, remember the snappy little number there, Gordon? What is that snappy little number?
It's the 27443-01 for our American viewers, and there we know their love of Wago terminal over there.
Yeah, so we can see now we've got loads more space, which is what we wanted.
Yep.
Okay, we've got 60 terminals, which is fantastic, and we've got the ability to bring 12 cord grips in, as well as entrance from the back. So I think now we've made it bigger, which it needed to be, but it solved all the problems.
Well, let's have a look at what it looks like on our rig, because we've wired one up already.
Okay, so let's have a come over and have a look. Well, that looks better already.
So you can see on this one, we've arranged the neutral terminals there. So you need lots of neutrals in a central heating system. There's the incoming line conductors and masses of CPC conductors down that side. Our double stacked cable entries. And this configuration, so it's good that it doesn't come fully loaded, because obviously central heating systems are changing. Also, this product is obviously aimed at multi-zone valves on underfloor central heating systems. But with these, heating's changing all the time, the fact you can configure it to the exact needs is, I think is fantastic. And
I've got some space. Look, so you haven't used them here, and you haven't used the ones in the back either. So there's plenty more opportunities to make connections in there. I like that. So I think almost Wago created a bit of their own problem. They tried the L32 and it wasn't big enough, was it? There wasn't
close.
Enough terminals. Yeah, close, but not quite there, was it?
Yeah. And obviously some people are going to say, there's not much room. Often, the plumber never leaves you much room. You're right. So you want to get in there first and make sure you've got the room to fit them. Okay, you've got the L32 if you want to fight the wires in. But this is a great solution.
Yeah, it is a great solution. And we think now this product, unlike its probably predecessor, this product will make electricians' life easier with those 60 levered connections that we can put our conductors in, making it nice and screwless as well. And we think this is a really good product from Wago. Just remind me of the code again, please, when I get the wholesaler.
It's the 207-4301.
Slips off the tongue just like that, doesn't it? So as always, here at eFIXX, we're interested in your comments. Have you fitted the 207-4301 box before? And if you have, how did you get on with it? Was it an improvement on what you've been doing before you used this box? Are you thinking about using it in the future? Please leave those comments below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.